A natural leader, joyful learner, and dedicated and talented student, Al Johnson embodies the characteristics that St. Paul Academy and Summit School value most. Thank you. Yeah. President of the Student Council, Al directed the student government with poise, charm, and humor as she led assemblies and served as a valuable liaison between the student body and the faculty and administration. Al coordinated the school's highly successful Speaker Day, not to gain the spotlight, but because she had a genuine desire to ensure that the program was done well and provided an interesting and valuable experience for the student body. Her dedication to the school and to her peers is exceptional, and she has brought her heart and her talents to projects that have made positive impacts in every area of student life. An outstanding student, motivated by enthusiasm and a spirit of inquiry, Al earned a perfect 4.0 GPA as a senior in a challenging curriculum that included honors classes in math, science, and history. Al is also a talented debater, compiling an excellent record against the toughest competition and serving as an emotional and tactical keystone for the large and successful team. Al's thoughtful precision and deep analysis in history were noted when she received that department's Margolis Award for excellence in the study of United States government. Al was also recognized this year as a National Merit Finalist, and she was inducted into the school's chapter of the Cum Laude Society earlier this spring. Kind, respectful, independent, imaginative, and focused, Al is an extraordinary student and exemplary citizen. She has set the bar high for future student leaders at SPA. Congratulations, Al.
We talk a great deal in this country about the virtues of public service. John Doerr is the embodiment of the power and purpose of public service. He's been at the nexus of events that have defined the arc of American culture and values. In his unwavering commitment to justice and equality, John Doerr has asserted the primacy of legal and moral standards to which our nation aspires in its best moments. SPA is proud to claim him as one of our graduates. I am indeed honored to introduce him as the commencement speaker for the class of 2011. Ladies and gentlemen, John Doerr.
Now, you can trace the civil rights movement from the sit-ins in 1960 in North Carolina to the freedom rides in Montgomery in 1961 to the violence in Southwest Mississippi in 1961 and 62 to the entrance of James Meredith into the University of Mississippi in 1962, to the demonstrations in Greenwood, Mississippi and Birmingham, Alabama in 1963, to the summers of 1964 when the white students went down to Mississippi for a Mississippi summer, to the development of the Mississippi Freedom Democratic Party by Bob Moses, a SNCC leader, and his companions, to the efforts that the Freedom Democratic Party of Mississippi made to be seated at the Democratic Convention. And those events all led, inevitably, to Selma, Alabama in early 1965, and after Selma came the Voting Rights Act of 1965, and the world changed. The world changed. Think of it. Why did the world change? Because before that, in many, many places in the South, counties in the South, 2 to 5% of the black citizens were allowed to vote, whereas every white person who was a resident of the county voted if he could breathe. There was only one criteria, he could breathe. There was no education standard that was applied to whites. There was no intelligence standard that was applied to whites. And it was a very exceedingly corrupt and denigrating system.
It is now my honor to present the 2011 Faculty Bowl.
The faculty bowl is awarded to that senior who has shown unusual breadth and depth of intellectual interest and outstanding commitment to academic excellence. Quick-minded and facile in all academic subjects, Stephen Wedderburn is remarkable for the scope and depth of his talents, passions, and achievements. Stephen excelled in our highest offerings in math, science, history, and two world languages. He maintained a strong commitment to the music program, serving as concertmaster, excelled as a competitive swimmer, served as an articulate voice of compassion and clarity on the Student Faculty Discipline Committee, and on top of all that, took at least one independent study course in every year of high school, covering four different academic disciplines. Distinguished by his insatiable curiosity and desire to learn, Stephen is genuinely thoughtful and generous with his considerable talents. He never hesitates to help classmates who admire his achievements and value his presence and his leadership. Stephen also shares his many talents with those outside of our community through coaching swimming at the Courage Center and playing violin at a local nursing home, in addition to performing with the Greater Twin Cities Youth Symphony and playing in the orchestra pit for every school production. Stephen was named a semifinalist in the Presidential Scholar Competition, one of fewer than 600 in the nation. And as a National Merit Finalist, Stephen was awarded a prestigious corporate-sponsored scholarship. Within the school, Stephen won a book award for his dedication to the music program, won the Excellence Award for his work in Spanish, and was inducted into the school's chapter of the Cum Laude Society. Throughout his academic career, Stephen has embodied a potent mixture of joyful learning and serious scholarship. His teachers recognize his passion for learning, intense curiosity, and keen intellect. These are standards by which they measure the most successful and inspirational of students. Congratulations, Stephen.
The head of school bowls are awarded to those members of the senior class who have been recognized by their peers and teachers for significant contributions to the school. The award is symbolic both of the school's values and of the many achievements of the class of 2011. In selecting the recipients of the head bowl, I rely on the advice and counsel of the upper school faculty. This year, their counsel has been very helpful, and there are three recipients in 2011. Quietly self-assured and intellectually curious is how teachers describe this impressive young man. A member of Cum Laude, he is a quiet leader in class, never drawing attention to himself or forcing his views on others, all of which serves to make his contributions and discussions all the more powerful and influential. In addition to enrolling in a host of honors courses, he added an independent study in economics in his junior year, working with a teacher and a small group of peers on the economics coursework provided by Massachusetts Institute of Technology. As he advanced through the highest levels of our Spanish program, he decided to add 2 years of German study. His teacher describes him as one of the most gifted German students I have ever had the privilege to teach. His intelligence, discipline, and integrity serve him admirably in a variety of pursuits beyond the classroom. He has been a member and captain of our varsity soccer and tennis teams, each of which advanced well into the state playoffs. He has been a leader of SPA's debate team. As a senior, he enjoyed one of the best years in SPA debate history, winning 5 of 6 debates at the Harvard Invitational and qualifying for the national debate tournament in Dallas. Recognized by students and the faculty for his strong leadership on the discipline committee, he is successful in that role for the same reasons he finds such success in academics, debate, and athletics. He approaches his varied responsibilities with a rare mixture of thoughtfulness, intellectual acuity, and passion, all overlaid with a deep personal integrity. Please join me in congratulating Zach Mooring, and best wishes, Zach, as you move on to Yale University.